I have opportunities to present our rapid mortality, rapid and nutritional mortality in Banki area in north of Nigeria. Okay, since 2014, attack by Boko Haram have intensified in northeast Nigeria, leading to the displacement of almost 3 million of population across Chad, Niger, Cameroon, and as well as Nigeria. In mid-2015, most of the territory that was controlled by Boko Haram in northwest Nigeria has now been taken over by Nigeria Army. This situation produces a massive displacement into area that are comparable to the camp. MSF was present in several camps in Nigeria. As you can see in the map, as well as in Cameroon and Chad. Actually, Banki was closer to confinement place than a camp. There are between 15 and 25,000 people were there, and people were confined there for more than 6 months, and people living in extremely depriving conditions. For example, there are no markets in Banki. There are limited movement of population. There are limited access to safe drinking water and sanitation. Also, humanitarian assistance was mainly managed by Nigeria Army and local volunteers. MSF did an initial nutrition and mortality assessment in Banki in July. At the same time, we implement a blanket filling and measles vaccination of children under 5, as well as distribution of non-food items. A rapid assessment show a crude mortality rate 4 times above emergency threshold, as well as very high level of nutrition. To address this critical situation, we implement from July to December a strategy combined preventive, curative, as well as water sanitation activities. Preventive was measles vaccination for all children under 15 years, 3 rounds of seasonal malaria chemo preventive, and vitamin distribution. The main focus of medical care was nutritional care, because malnutrition rate was so high. So we decided to keep pits as simple as we could. We use MIAC only for screening. We use pimpinut only for all children. For children with severe malnutrition, we give 13 sachets Plumpinut, and for all other children, we give 15 sachets Plumpinut. So all children was given Plumpinut. We think this is very important. In addition, we give families protection ration of high energy biscuits, as well as mosquito net, and so. In order to monitor the situation and the effects of MSF intervention, MSF, in collaboration with Epicentre, decided to implement regular mortality survey I am going to... to talk about the method. We did a repeated mortality survey. We use randomly systematic simplest to select household. And for data collection, we use a simplified form counted only 6 main variables. We also define very short recall period to limit any bias. We did 3 mortality survey, and the last survey, we investigate also malnutrition. You can see on my slide the result. The main result you can see here is about the crude mortality trend. The crude mortality rate decreased from 3 deaths per 10,000 people per day to 0.3 deaths per 10,000 people per day. The under 5 mortality rate decreased from 5.6 deaths per 10,000 people per day to 1.7 and to 1 respectively across the time. Most of the deaths come in Bangui, not during the displacement of population. In the third survey, we have a malnutrition, and we can see that a global acute malnutrition was 1.6, and several acute malnutrition was 0.2. We have some limitation for our survey. We didn't collect individual data, so it was not possible to describe age pyramids. Arrival and departure not take into account. No repeated malnutrition survey, so we can't follow malnutrition trend over the time. What about the conclusion? So we present here an overview of humanitarian emergencies in Bangui and effort of MSF time to provide assistance in a tenacious security situation. Despite difficult access team, MSF team could organize a comprehensive target package through intermittent visits. The light repetitive survey was able to replace the surveillance system due to the high insecurity and with limited access of MSF to the Bangui area. I want to acknowledge communities of Bangui, MSF flight staff and driver in Cameroon, and MSF staff in Geneva and in Paris. Thank you.